Hi guys, we are here in the Paddy HQ office in Bristol, the Paddy head office for Europe, Middle East and Africa. I am the regional manager, Emma Hewitt, the regional manager for the south of the UK and Ireland. And I'm here with Richard Cullen, who is the founder of Depth Therapy Education. So Richard has come over to our Bristol office to train some of our staff here in the office with the depth therapy education course and looking at doing the adaptive techniques instructor program as well. So Richard, first of all, thank you so much for coming over and joining us today. Always fantastic to work with you. So tell us a little bit about depth therapy education, first of all.
Right, there's two parts to the charity. First part is depth therapy, which most people understand, which is where we take seriously injured armed service veterans and try to rehabilitate them through scuba diving. The second part is depth therapy education, which we formed back in 2014 because we actually thought there was a huge gap in the market from the other providers of disabled diving, if you like. But we wanted to focus it on adaptive teaching so that we could actually get people to achieve PADI standards. That is always our aim on our program. So that's where we like to go. We actually say, you know, that's our main cutoff point, is actually somebody being able to achieve PADI standards and finding very innovative ways for them to do that.
Yeah, fantastic. And of course, you've had so many great successes with some of the guys coming through your program, and you're seeing some of them now really progressing on through the courses.
Yeah, we are. I mean, we've got Chris Middleton, is a dive master, and I've got to say, on our last course in May at Roots in Red Sea, he was absolutely stunning. I think probably one of the best dive masters I've ever seen. But he now is going to progress to do his IDC and his IE, and I think he'll make a stunning instructor. But underneath Chris, we've got other people now as trainee dive masters, all aiming to achieve that and wanted to go on to be instructors.
Absolutely. So what would you say to those who are maybe thinking that diving isn't something that would be possible for them? What would you say to that kind of group of people?
Diving is pretty much possible for all people. There are some limitations, there are some illnesses that prevent people from diving. Certainly in the UK, the HSE has designated bipolar and epilepsy as two illnesses where you can't dive. But you can dive and achieve PADI standards. So we've got triple amputees who are achieving advanced open water deep courses. One of them's doing his rescue course on our next trip. People who have injuries worse than that, say that are tetraplegic, lost use of all four limbs, can still experience diving in a pool or if they're capable to, you know, discover scuba diving, diving in the ocean. People with motor neuron disease can dive in a pool. They might be able to dive in the sea, but it's a question of assessment. So basically, scuba diving is pretty much open to most of those people with disabilities.
Yeah, absolutely. And we know that, of course, you know, it can have such great healing effects on people with disabilities or injuries. You've certainly seen that through a lot of your guys who have come through the program.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of physical injury, being weightless is like being in a huge hydrotherapy bath. Yeah. They don't feel pain. The pain actually goes when they're neutrally buoyant. There's no pain at all, and there is some evidence that pain stays away for some time after the dive. For those who are suffering from mental illness and particularly PTSD, they also, once they put their head under the water, that's it. There's no noise. They're completely relaxed. The demons go away. Yeah. But of course, what you have to provide as well is support after that event, because actually you come out and you've had this either a marvellous trip away for a week in the Red Sea, and you go back with the holiday blues, but it's a bit worse if you've got PTSD. So people do need support, and what we have to manage, and I know it's in the new manual for the Paddy Adaptive Techniques program, you have to manage expectations of the people you're actually working with.
Yeah, very true. So what would you say as well to those who are instructors who are wanting to get involved with this type of community and get those type of people into the water?
Well, I actually think it's I've learned so much since I started working with people with injuries and illnesses back in 2010, and I never stopped learning.
Yeah.
And it actually changes how you deal with every client you have for scuba diving. And I'd urge everybody to get involved with that, because if you know what you're doing and somebody comes into your dive centre who has a disability and wants to dive, whether that's just in the pool or they want to go on to be an open water diver if they're actually capable of doing that, it's best you know the techniques, and it's best you know where the pitfalls are, and it's best you understand about medicals, and it's best you understand about how people with disabilities perceive society, and unfortunately how we inadvertently make judgments about people with disabilities and actually think they've got limitations.
Well, brilliant. Well, thank you so much. I'm certainly very excited to go into this course. Really looking forward to working with yourself and the other program members on it. So if you do want to get yourself involved in the Adaptive Techniques program, then do look it up on paddy.com and on the pro site as well, and get in contact with us for more information. So thank you so much.